Well, joining us now, Baker Mayfield. And it struck me this morning, Baker, what a difference a year makes. I mean, this time last year, you were getting ready for the pre-draft process. We were talking about the draft, where you'd go. Now you sit here as a nominee, a Pepsi nominee for Rookie of the Year. How different do you feel this time around?
I'll tell you what, it's a lot more relaxing this time around, going to the Super Bowl, doing all these interviews, having the draft process is stressful. It's a long, brutal process. So what a difference a year makes.
You did probably one of the most difficult things you can as a player. You're changing expectations of fans in a city there where they got used to losing. Can you talk about how it was when you first got there and then to win at the end of the rookie year and how people just sort of were starting to look at your franchise differently?
Yeah, no, to be honest with you, when I got there, you could feel it kind of changing already. You could feel the pieces there from free agency and the draft, our draft class they brought in.
Amongst players, you had a little attitude that it could change?
You could feel it from inside the locker room that we had key pieces. We had a special team. We just needed to find out our identity and kind of come together. As you know, the culture is – to be able to change a culture into a winning culture is very important.
Well, you know, a big part of changing that culture will certainly be your new head coach, Freddie Kitchens. And it seemed from the outside looking in, and correct me if I'm wrong, that you two kind of hit it off and found some sort of common ground. What allowed that to happen so quickly, Baker?
Just open communication, a lot of honesty, just being upfront about, you know, what he wanted to get accomplished, you know, how we wanted to do it, and just talking throughout the week during game plans, you know, just eliminating stuff that we didn't like or just where to get my eyes, eliminate quicker. And so it was a very, you know, upfront relationship from the very beginning.
I can look in some of my past seasons I can look at certain weeks where this was the week where we thought something clicked or this was the week when we thought something changed. This year throughout your rookie year, was there a specific week where you said, that point right there, when that happened, I knew that we were on the right track?
You know what? As sad as this sounds, because losing's never fun, but when we were competing with the Chiefs, you know, I felt like we had them in the first half. It was really close, but we just had a few plays not go our way. And just to see that we were competing with, you know, at that time when we played the Chiefs, they were on a roll.
Yeah, they were on a roll.
And so looking back on it, we realized at that point, you know, we have something here. And so then going into the next week, we played the Falcons and everything. It was just like it kind of clicked right away. So that point in the season was a lot of fun.
When you realize we have something here, you know, and that light bulb kind of that switch flips, you know, what's next then? What do you have to do to build on that and make sure it continues in the right direction? Because, you know, it can go either way.
Oh, absolutely. You know, believing it, it's one thing, you know, having people to trust the game plan, but then going out there and just executing is another. So, you know what, it came down to our guys just believing in the plan, just doing their jobs, and just every person did their 1/11th on the team. And so that was important.
Yeah. 1/11th.
1/11th, right. Always. Yeah, it was awesome.
You've got a lot of young leaders on the team, yourself, some great rookies out there. Mm-hmm. You know, Myles Garrett is developing into one of the best defensive ends in the league. Do you see the young leadership forming on that team?
Oh, absolutely. You know, we have two great players in Nick Chubb and Denzel Ward, you know, in my draft class that they're very quiet leaders. They're not going to talk very much, and neither is Myles. So we got guys like Jabril Peppers on the defensive side of the ball. So, you know, we have a bunch of young guys that are, you know, they're starting to believe in it. We're starting to come together. And so that's very important. It's very important for me now to take that vocal leadership role and kind of roll with it.
When you're out in Cleveland having a beer, doing whatever, what's the biggest, what's the most common comment you get? I know it's only been a few weeks.
It's
ones you can repeat.
It's definitely, hey, how you feeling? And they're expecting me to say dangerous every single time without a doubt.
I'm not going to lie, Teddy's been itching all day to ask.
Okay, speaking of dangerous, all right, sometimes I would wake up in the morning and it's like, you're right, you feel like this is a win, this is definitely, we can't be beat. So when you wake up in the morning and you open your eyes, what gives you that thing where dangerous? What is it?
Teddy, he's actually happy now.
I've been saying that for a while, but it was, you know that feeling. You just wake up one day and you're like, wow, it's going to be a good day.
Can't be beat.
And on game day, it's always that feeling.
What's the offseason look like for you, Baker? Because we always look at quarterbacks and we talk about that jump.
Yeah.
A tough call for you because you set the bar pretty high, but that jump between your rookie season and your sophomore year, so to speak. What's the offseason look like?
I've been relaxing for a little bit. Now I'm here, going to enjoy the game, and then get to go back to Cleveland this week and meet the new staff. And so looking forward to that. Dive into, you know, what they want to do and, you know, be able to get the receivers out before, you know, mandatory mini camp and, you know, just kind of come together. Because I think it's important for our guys to step away. I think it's very important to kind of unplug for a little bit. But looking forward to meeting our new staff.
There's a shift that's going to occur that you're going to notice when the season comes around, and a lot of people won't be calling you guys the perennial losers. They'll actually, some may pick you to win the division next year. So those expectational shifts, that type of attitude, can you still manufacture that chip on your shoulder that you've lived with your entire life?
Absolutely. That's not a problem for me. And so that's why my leadership role now, I think, is to install that with everybody else. And so, you know, expectations never matter. It's what you do when it comes down to it. And I've always been one, and Coach Riley back at Oklahoma said it to me many a time, set your own expectation. Nobody else matters.
I don't think you have to worry. The Patriots have won like 49 Super Bowls, and they're still the underdogs. So,
still don't
listen.
Have respect.
Are you
okay, yeah,
right?
Here we go. Listen, it can be done.
That's an easy pick for me.
How happy are you, Baker, to be talking about Rookie of the Year and 27 touchdown passes and the Browns changing culture than your height, which is what I think we were talking about this time last year?
Oh, that's the fun part about it. You know, that draft process is brutal, like I said, but you know, it's fun now, you know, being in the conversation for Rookie of the Year against one of my good friends, Saquon. And so it's a fun process. It's so surreal for me to be going through it. A dream come true.
Yeah, there's draft classes. Then there's quarterback draft classes. Like, we still talk about Manning, Roethlisberger, Rivers, those type of things. I mean, your quarterback class. And also, I wanted to ask you about competing against Lamar Jackson for, I mean, what is it going to be, the next decade or so in your division?
Yeah, no, I'm looking forward to that. You know, going through that process with those guys, you get very close with them. And so that was special as it is. But then competing against him twice a year now is going to be a lot of fun for a long time.